Hey guys, your worker person, welcome back to my FIFA 16 Liverpool promo, where last time I left off, if you didn't see my live stream on Monday, you're gonna be really confused as why I'm at the first leg of the Real Madrid game. But yes, I did live stream on Monday, and I'm now a bit further ahead. Had completed out the January transfer window, won all my matches because I am the best. And now I play the Galacticos, the Real Madrid themselves. The game isn't giving me an easy run to that Champions League trophy. And I wouldn't have it any other way. The second is so it's the Capital One Cup final, and I'm gonna throw in a third game, my league game against Arsenal. Oh, and I'll explain to that match. But first, let's take down Real. However, not a bad lineup for the last regular video of 2015. Real Madrid, Chelsea, and Arsenal whole match is Champions League a final and a very important league match. Like I said, I'll talk about more that when the time comes. Of course, Neymar is returning to Spain only a month after I signed him away from Barcelona. And of course, like the Gareth Bale and Varane are playing against their former club. And it's a bit ironic, I'd feel, that I'm coming up against Real Madrid, considering Cristiano Ronaldo could easily be in the player I signed in the window, but I didn't. Neymar was the one who was chosen, and well, with the way he's been banging goals, I'm definitely not in the slightest bit displeased. Ooh, almost a early good start for Real Madrid there from Karim Benzema, denied by the post. I have to be more careful there. Come on, Gareth. Oh, that's an early foul there by Luka Modric. Not letting his former Spurs and Real Madrid teammate get away from him. Not easily, anyway. Well, here's a Laporte, who's also returning to Spain from who I got from LA Bilbao. It's pretty much my first team, except Coutinho was way too tired. Didn't save me using up one of my substitutions. I just put in Otze instead. Oh! That's twice they've hit the fucking post. I gotta really be more careful. That was Ronaldo that time. After Benzema's early strike against the woodwork. Sergio Ramos was still up from the corner, and James's shot isn't his best. Let's put it that way. And Correa is another one. So a very La Liga, a heavy squad I have. With a load of ex La Liga players. La Liga and Bundesliga, for sure, are definitely, popular leagues. For this particular squad. Keeper is actually an ex La Liga player as well. He came from was it Real Sociedad? Yeah, it was Real Sociedad. So the former club of David Moyes. Of course, not anymore. He was sacked quite a few months ago. Oopsie. Dumb bastard. Us. Yeah, I'm not having a good time against Real Madrid. They are, this is probably the only match where I've struggled so far. Yo, what the hell? Oh, and it's gonna take one moment of brilliance, isn't it? It's gonna be Correa! Yes! There's the moment of brilliance I was looking for. Very well played. Marcel was looking for offside. How about you defend next time there, Marcelo? Dumbass, just standing around. Like, it's important. Even if you are trying to play the offside, you should be alert in case it fucks up. It could be 2-0! And it is! Neymar sets up onto his over 2-0. That was his quick strike in succession, and Real Madrid suddenly aren't much in this anymore. Bit of a tap in, but they all count. And Odesell's not gonna complain. I'm not gonna complain. Real Madrid might, but nobody gives a shit it whether they here gonna complain or not. So that's immaterial. His third goal in the Champions League, considering he has not played in the Champions League yet for me. That must mean he scored two goals for Bremen. Didn't even think they'd be in the Champions League. Oh, yeah, I'm thinking he was on loan with Werder Bremen the first season. Leverkusen are his, were his. So never mind. Oh, Neymar. If I can get past Pep, this could be 3-0. It is 3-0. Oh, all of a sudden the scoring has gone from 0-0 to 3-0. Blink and you'll feckin' miss it. Neymar scores his first Champions League goal for me. His fourth of the competition. All of a sudden, in just under 10 minutes, it went from 0-0 to 3-0. Speaking of Barcelona, they are beating Olympiacos 1-0. Expecting more than that. That's, come on, Barca. There's Neymar to Klein. Henderson. Oh wow, that was a shit pass. Luckily, Ricardo got it back. Here's Marco Reus. There, her dumbass. What the hell? Oh, for the. I was gonna say for his second of the game. I mean, for 4-0. Shot is a bit too high there, her friend. Luckily, Jordan Henderson makes sure that Madrid don't enter into a counter attack. Yes, Henderson gets the ball from Ronaldo. It's not very easy to do. Ah, but he gets one back by cutting out the pass that was intended for Henderson by. Yeah. What's his L? Royce. Just keeps it in. Modric clears it. Fucker. Brain. Cross out here to Bale. Bale going up against Ronaldo. Decides Klein is the better option. Well, I decided Klein was the better option. Nathaniel Klein! Oh, imagine! That would have been a hell of a moment in Klein's young career. A goal against Real Madrid. Not something any. It's not something everyone can say. Hey, that was a hell of a shot there at Americ. Not sure what he was going for. If I'm being honest, I was hoping it would take a deflection nor bounce to one of my players in the box, but neither of those things happened. It went straight out. Neymar. Royce. Marco Royce! Oh, Cruz. Now you get in the way. Hey? Jackass. Correa! The deflection. Could have made it difficult for Silla, but he was equal to it. Ricardo Rodriguez. What is James Rodriguez doing back here defending? Penalty! Of course not. Neymar? Yes, it doesn't matter. Neymar scores again. And it's 4-0. That's a pretty comfortable lead considering I'm against Real Madrid. Considering they hit the post and were dominating at the start of this match. Not gonna sugarcoat it. Real Madrid were way better at the start of this match. I was maybe not off to the best to start, but I've definitely made up for that. And now, I have a very comfortable lead all of a sudden. Look, I don't know if Liverpool once upon a time did beat Real Madrid 5-0. That was a well. Seems so long ago now, doesn't it? Neymar! He's gonna get another chance at it! Oh! The hat trick and the 5-0. Oh. So how the hell did he make that double save? Penalty! Probably would have been a soft penalty. Nathaniel Klein! Ooh! Silla, he had to be alert. It was on target, so it probably would have gone in had he not been alert. Is the Porte gonna get there? I don't think he got there. No. Marco Reus. No. Casilla is equal to that. Should be it. Yeah. There it is. There's the full-time whistle. 4-0 will do. That's a nice, comfortable. Oh. Advantage to take into the second leg. Hey, remember they're gonna need to score 4 goals against. Me, at Anfield. In a season where I've only conceded 3 goals all season to this point. So, yeah, I wouldn't hold my breath if I was them. And anyway, hey, on to the Capital One Cup final. Bring home another bit of silverware, just to pile on to my already legacy of being the best manager ever. Well, here we are for the conclusion of this. Chelsea are going to have a vital part to play in why the Arsenal game will be so key. Again, and like I said, I will talk about that more when I play against Arsenal, but right now, it's all about winning the Capital One Cup. Start out here, go to Rice. An early goal for Coutinho! Yes, indeedy! 4 minutes in. Coutinho's like, thank you very much. He will score. Alright. So I tried to keep it out, but there was nothing he could really have done. If that did stay out, there were other red shirts around waiting for their opportunity. Second goal in the Capital One Cup, and it's 1-0. Oh, good start for Chelsea. Say the least. Here's William. Ivanovic. Ricardo Rodriguez. Neymar. Marco Reus. Real good contest between these two as they jostle for possession. Neymar! Ooh, Courtois was equal to that one, though. Reus. Laporte. Go for it! Ooh, he was... He almost... He almost got the reward for having a pop. Another good save from the Belgian goalkeeper of Chelsea. Coutinho's header is cleared away by Mikel. Diego, I've got anger problems. Costa. Henderson. It's come back to Henderson, and he's put it over the bar. Brilliant. So far, so good, Jordan. Daniel Klein somehow kept that. But Coutinho lost it. No harm done. He's probably gonna get back here from his fellow Brazilian Ramirez. Sure did. Here's Royce. Back to Henderson. Over to Nathaniel Clyne. Oh, Hazard. He read the pass. Yes. Dick. Come on. If I can get the ball off Azpilicueta, which I have. Here's Bale. Oh, now Chelsea are on the defensive again. Henderson! Oh, Mikel, you lucky son of a gun. What a lucky sod. Chelsea should give Mikel a new contract on that alone. That has kept them in this. That was destined for the back of that. Yeah, because Courtois was in Noma. And it wasn't exactly. On his way to preventing that going in. It was purely the work of John Obi Mikel. Oh. Nathaniel Clyne. What a ball to Neymar! Oh, Courtois with his knees, he saved it. Off his kneecap. Or his upper shin. Either way, it's a fantastic save by the Belgian. And Royce! And another one. Son of a. Costa's header is gonna go out for a throw. I don't think anyone could have gotten to that. Regardless of speed. I wasn't expecting Williams' touch to. I was going for a tackle, that's why he, Royce went for like a shot, because, you know, circles tackle as well. I wasn't expecting Willian's touch to pretty much gift me the ball. Well, at the end of that first half, but 1-0 at the break. Probably should be more, but what can you do against one of the best keepers in the world? And when Chelsea, he. Have a lot of good defensive-minded players like John Obi Mikel, who are when Courtois can't, they are in the right place at the right time. What a ball for Correa! Back to Coutinho. Oh, and Mikel was there again. He cut out the pass. If that had gotten to Coutinho, we'd be looking at 2-0. Or at least we would have seen another fantastic save. But my money would have been on 2-0. Bell. Ivanovich wasn't taking any risks. He got rid of it to prevent 2-0, but he's giving me a corner which could easily lead to 2-0 anyway. Coutinho! Courtois was equal to it. It probably would have just went straight at Ramirez, who would have cleared it anyway, so either way, Chelsea were covered. That's Chelsea's next game. Need a little help from the Geordies. There's the confirmation that I will be playing Arsenal next. Big matches. Big matches. Because I'll get into that more. Or after this match. When Cuadrado is on for Willian. No, Bell, no, no, no! Oh, come on, Gareth, for fuck's sake, keep it in. There's Costa. Yes, Laporte wins it from him. Neymar! Bury it! Yes, there it is! Finally! You didn't keep that one out, did you, you Belgian and prick? Neymar finally doubles my lead. Well, I finally double my lead. It just happened to be Neymar who scored it. It's all the Brazilians today. Hey for my team. Coutinho getting the first goal and Neymar getting the second. His second goal in the Capital One Cup. Just widen the margin here to 2-0. Very crucial one, because that's put me one step closer to retaining the Capital One Cup. Love a third goal just to make absolute sure of it. Hell, made a bit of a mistake there, because the ball fell to, well, I don't know if you could count that as a mistake, but wasn't exactly a good defensive move compared to his other person in this match. Henderson! It would have been ironic for the captain to finish up the match and then go get the trophy, considering it's only the captain whoever is shown lifting the trophy. The others just sort of celebrate. Oh, and El's shot is again saved by Courtois. There goes Chelsea's outfield best player. And here comes Lorc Remy. And by there. Best outfield player I meant of the match, obviously. In terms of ability in real life, Mikel is probably the furthest thing from Chelsea's best player. Then again, you wouldn't be able to tell who Chelsea's best player this season is with how bad they're playing in real life. Daniel Klein, Correa! Oh, that's gonna go in! Yes! That might go down as an own goal, to be honest. I couldn't give a rat's ass, though. It's 3-0. Yo, not sure how much he knew about it. But, Did it even touch him? It definitely looked like it touched him. Oh, must have. Be pretty freaking, let's see who it gives it to. Oh, it's giving it his career's goal. He's not gonna complain. He wraps up the trophy. Bit surprised that didn't go down as an own goal. Well, if I'm being honest. Again, not that it matters. But, yeah, there you go. Once Courtois kicks it out, it should be over. Come on, ref. 3-0 in the 19th minute. There we go. There it is. His another trophy for the cabinet. Winning the Capital One Cup isn't exactly, you know, it's an achievement, it's a trophy. Is it the best trophy to win? No. Does it matter? No. It doesn't matter in the slightest at all. Why would it? Well, your stats went up, Kamano, but you didn't. You know, you're just chilling there on 77. I should go up to 77, hopefully, in the next training session. But first, the all-important Arsenal game. And see, Arsenal found fourth place because United have played a game more. It's not going to help that they're playing against me. Are you kidding me? God damn it. Or he won't. Son of a bitch. Of course. Of fucking course. It's always when you're trying to make them good that they get fucking injured, isn't it? Right. I have to figure that out. Yeah, Chan, no, you're not leaving. Your squad rotation. Dude, you're playing as much as is possible. I was gonna say, hey, it's telling me to remove Ibe from my bench. That's what. Players are a bit tired, but they need to be on the pitch for what could happen in this match. Because this could be the winning of the league. If I win and Chelsea do not win against Newcastle, I will win the league. Yeah, that's why this match is so important. And if Chelsea do win, then I will secure the league title in my next game against Swansea. But I want to secure it against, it's a bit of a bigger club. No offense to Swansea, but, you know, sealing it against Arsenal, well, considering they have been one of the teams, you're not going to see this, I'm doing air quotes, chasing me this season. They've been you, sort of near. Not really. No one has come even close to me this season. And Arsenal must somehow stop me from beating them to keep this. I'd call it a pathetic tire race, but that would be an insult to pathetic tire races. Like, this is domination you wouldn't even see in the Bundesliga or league. From Bayern or PSG. Neymar. There we go. Czech's record breaker card didn't help him there, did it? Neymar scores again. And we're on our way to a second consecutive league title. Oh, it's an own goal. Oh, but that one's an own goal, but the Gilk one in the Kappa One Cup final wasn't. Right. Interesting. Interesting. They're at EA? Doesn't really matter. Or does it? No. No is the answer to that. I'm here to win. It doesn't matter who scores the goals. I could have my keeper come up and score. It wouldn't matter. Correa! Oh, it's my turn to hit the post. I got lucky against Real Madrid when both Bale and Benzema. Sorry, Ronaldo and Benzema hit the post. And it's Correa who's denied by the post this time. Neymar! Ooh! That didn't go as planned. Well, I guess second goal nice and early. Neymar. Who's waiting? Free kick. Thank you very much. Nice ascent, so that help Henderson up. Correa! interesting choice. And go. Oh, he's like, bicycle kick. Why not? He almost clobbered the Arsenal player there. I think it was a 22. Was it Bellerin? No, not Bellerin. Giroud gets the ball off Klein and clears it, but not very far. Oh, Verratti. It was Verratti. Bell. Coutinho. Neymar. Marco Reus. Correa. Nathaniel Klein. What's he doing up there? It doesn't really matter. He scored. 2-0 from a likely goal scorer in Neymar to a very unlikely goal scorer. Then saying that, he scored a few goals just last season, but this season as well. Oh. Oh. Nathaniel Klein. Probably his most important goal so far, if I'm being honest. The defense has abandoned Arsenal. It's going to be 3-0. Oh, too easy. Not sure where Arsenal's defense went for that. I'm not going to complain. It's 3-0. Oh, Czech is just as confused as I am. I'm about where the defense are. Like, there's just a big gap there that Neymar is in. All on his own. Debussy is over here for some reason. And Arsenal fans, you must be absolutely lit. If that happened in real life, Arsenal fans would be so pissed. 15 goals already. He's only been here a month, and he's already on 15 goals. Was it worth 94.5 million? Yes. Very much so if he keeps banging in the goals. He was going to catch Coutinho at this rate. Oh! Wow, I did not expect that. Olivier Giroud spoiled the party. Sorta, kinda. Third goal conceded in the league. That's not a foul, really. No, I did just see Chelsea are now 2-0 up against Newcastle. It looks like looks like it'll be against Swansea where I win the league. Ooh! Fanny Klein going for a brace! What odds would it be for fucking Nathaniel Klein to score a fucking hat trick? I wonder when the last time a defender scored. Any defender scored a hat trick. Must be a long time ago. Oh. Get rid of it! Fucking switched off there a sec. And get rid of that. Correa. There's halftime. 3-1. Fortunately, it's not going to be the league winning performance I would have liked. I could take Coutinho off to give him a bit of a rest. If that's the case, bring on Tielemans. Coutinho deserves a bit of a break, plus I'd like him to be fit when we do win the league against Swansea in the next episode. Tielemans almost immediately made a 4-1. Czech was lucky it didn't bounce in again. It would have been in our own goal. Because reasons. Ooh, two big games for Arsenal in a row after me. Their North London derby against Spurs. Of course, after this, they're going to be out of the title race anyway, so it's just going to be for pride. Well, they can still get points. Help them make sure they confirm Champions League football for themselves. But they're not going to be winning the league. Saying that they're probably already out of it, considering they're a few points behind Chelsea. I think it's only Chelsea who can still catch me. And I use the term catch very fucking lightly. They're gonna get a one game reprieve, and then I'm gonna claim the title against the Swans. Thing flashed up, but the scoreline didn't change. I can't hear the commentators, so I don't know what happened. There's confirmation of my game against Swansea. And it'd be better to win the title on home soil. Royce! Ooh, check almost made a fucking howler. Considering he's already can see an own goal from himself in this match. It's not been a good game for the experienced goalkeeper. Giroud's game is over. Here comes that guy Welbeck, as Arsenal fans like to call him. Bell, ooh! Speaking of Spurs, former Spurs player almost scored there. Here comes a Jack Wheelchair. Sorry, Wilshire. They're rolling him on in a wheelchair. That's what got me confused. Because he's always injured. Saying that, so is Daniel Sturridge. Correa! Oof! I probably should have passed that to Neymar, to be honest. Foul there by Santi Cazorla. Interesting substitution there by Arsene Wenger. He brought off a defender and brought on a midfielder. Right, obviously going to a 3-5-2, or else he's playing Campbell a fucking right back for whatever reason. Bell. Ball's come to Royce. Penalty. Which is almost over anyway. Out for a throw. Here to Henderson, who no one is watching. And from that throw, it's come to Neymar. Tillemans! Boom! Tillemans! And he doesn't always play. When he does, he usually gets a goal or an assist. Tillemans, a very dangerous player. And Arsenal learned that very abruptly. The 3 points, well, they've been sealed for a while. Well, the Giroud goal was just a consolation. I don't think anyone was expecting it to be anything other than a consolation. Fifth goal in the league for Tillemans. And get ready to win the league against Swansea. Is all that needs to be done now. Unless Newcastle somehow pulled it back against Chelsea. I didn't see anything come up, so I'm assuming Chelsea did win in 2-0. Oh, I'm okay with winning the league against Swansea. He on humps. Well, 4-1 win over Arsenal. Chelsea did it beat Newcastle by 2 goals. It was 3-1 in the end. There was 2 more goals. It became just designed. Nah, he didn't need to know about. So, There's that. So yeah. In the next episode, I will win the league in the first game by being Swansea. So don't you dare miss it or you'll regret it. But until then, thanks for watching. Hope you enjoyed. Like, comment, and subscribe if you did. And I will see you all next time. Peace. And I have a